Growing up in California, I was very aware of Charles Manson. My dad is from Southern California. My mom's from Northern California. They were both, you know, 13, 14 at the time of the Manson murders. So I grew up hearing all about him. He's sort of like a folktale in California, for sure. I feel like even now there's a lot of groups. I don't know if they're cults exactly, but definitely communes or intentional communities. I feel like California really attracts people who want a certain amount of freedom to recreate themselves or create a life that looks different than maybe what is normal. So I think in that way there'll always be sort of weirdos in California. I never considered writing a true crime book. I always wanted to write a novel. To me, like all the details and the actual facts of the Manson murders or any kind of murder are interesting as like a jumping off point, but I didn't want to have to sort of be a slave to the facts. And also I think in fiction, what I really wanted to do in this book, which I don't think I ever saw in any of the nonfiction I'd read about the Manson murders or any other sort of cults or anything that had interested me, is like the real psychology of someone on the periphery. So for me, fiction was a way to get into the head of someone who's on the edge of something. I wanted to write about a young girl who's 14 because I think that's a very specific age. It's sort of the moment when adolescence begins and sort of the moment when young girls come into this new sexual power but are still uncertain and not sure what it means exactly. And I think it's the moment when they have to confront themselves as an object in society, which is very tumultuous, I think, and a sad moment, but also interesting because it's so there's so much conflict. I wanted there to be an older version of Evie because I wanted there to be some breathing room. I feel like an adolescent's brain is so insane and everything is so black and white for a teenager that they really have no scale, no way of contextualizing their own experiences. So by having an older character, you get the context. And I also, what interested me about the Manson family and other sort of infamous cults are the people who are involved, but never did anything where they got arrested, and sort of how those people would live their lives, and what would it mean to them as adults in their 50s and 60s to have been involved in this thing, sort of how do they reckon with that? So the older Evie was a chance to sort of get into that psychology a little bit. I don't know. I liked writing. The younger Evie is more familiar to me because the age, it's closer to my age, and I've never been older, but I have been younger. So it was easier in that way. But it was also a little bit harrowing just to remember sort of what that was like. It really made me glad I'm no longer 14. I'm very happy not to be involved at all in the film stuff. I feel like so much of writing a novel is you sort of get all of your stuff out into this one thing. And so I'm sort of a little bit done with it. Like, I wouldn't want to think about it more than I have already. I'm very eager to, like, move on to the next book project. It felt nice, but I also sort of feel like it has nothing to do with me in a way. Like, I was working on the book and never really thought beyond finishing the book. So anything that happened after that was unexpected. But, yeah, ultimately has nothing to do with me or my job, which is just to keep writing books.